Jewish Museum of Australia is extremely excited that we're going to be hosting Amy Winehouse, A Family Portrait, this year. The exhibition has been co-curated by the Jewish Museum in London and Amy Winehouse's brother, Alex. The exhibition provides quite an intimate look at Amy's family life, her Jewish heritage, her relationship with her brother, as well as her early career aspirations and her very early passion and interest in music. Her sense of style, of course, was very important, and the exhibition will include wardrobe-style display cases. In them you'll see clothing that Amy wore both on stage and also some of her favourite items that people perhaps might not have seen before. Holding this exhibition at the museum will provide us with a great opportunity to have some late-night events accompanying the show. We can bring in local musicians and generally have a good time at the museum, I think, in celebration of this fantastic exhibition. In hosting this exhibition, it's provided the Jewish Museum with a really wonderful opportunity to connect with other Jewish museums around the world. They've been sharing their experiences with us of hosting the exhibition, and of course it's been a huge success wherever it's been. When the exhibition was first shown in London, they had 13,000 visitors in the first 2 months, and overall their visitation numbers increased by 300%. Amy Winehouse, A Family Portrait, will be our blockbuster exhibition for 2017.
She took an uncommercial sound to new places. She was a great live performer. Whereas there's so many artists that can make great records that can't perform live. In the early days, she loved touring, but touring can become a real mind and grind, etc. But look, I'm just proud that she was proud to be Jewish and never hid it. And I think that her legacy has been what her brother's achieved here, and the fact he didn't go in the media a lot was such a great thing. And what they've achieved with this whole thing is to show that this real girl was not sex, drugs and rock and roll. She was a fun, happy, captivating girl, and we were obviously very keen to bring her to Australia, but obviously the last couple of years of her life were really tragic, and maybe it's hard to understand, but a lot of artists have difficulty dealing with such success. She was a non-compromising girl, which made me very impressed with her. I've seen her perform a number of times, and look, it's just so sad. It's that magic age of 27, but she was, the times I saw her before it got pretty bad towards the end, there's people, for example, taking it in Australian terms, there are people that are happy, fun drunks, and there are people that just lose it. This girl was a happy high. She was so committed to her music.
There are a few key items in the exhibition that points to the fact that that was an important part of her life. A nice one is a Jewish cookbook given to her by Alex for her birthday, and in one of the front pages it says, in case of loss of faith, turn to page 75, and page 75 is chicken soup. Yeah.
Lots of family photos of her, you know, having traditional Friday night dinners or at her brother's bar mitzvah. It was a big part of her life, and I think it was a close family. How much that actually went, her Jewish heritage influenced her music sound, I'm not sure. It's an interesting one to consider. I'm not sure.
I think it influenced her in the sense that she had chutzpah, which means she was determined. She wanted to do it her way. She knew what she wanted. When she was in the studio, I know for a fact that if someone said to her, you're going to do it this way, if she didn't want to do it that way, she'd go bang, no matter who it was. And you've got to respect artists that try and take some control and have input in their careers rather than just being puppets. And most artists that are puppets are one or two at wonders and gone tomorrow.
I think not only because her family felt so strongly that in telling a story of who she was, it was the only place for it to be, but also because the nature of her Jewishness, like she wasn't religious, she wasn't observant, she didn't practice all of the traditional Jewish things, but there was something about her personality and the way she was in the world that was very Jewish. And I think that, you know, people often think of Jewish people in a particular way. They've got a particular image in their head. They assume it's about religious belief and practice, but there are so many other aspects that make up what it is to be Jewish. So this exhibition, I think, really gives us an opportunity to explore that through her particular story and personality. When I came, now what do you expect? You left me here alone. I drank so much, needed your touch. Now don't overreact. Yes, I pretended he was you, 'cause you wouldn't want me to be lonely. Now how can I put it so you'll understand? I didn't let him hold my hand, but he looked like you. Yes, he looked. But it wasn't you. No, he wasn't you. But you can still trust me. This ain't infidelity. No, it's not cheating. When you were on my mind, yes, he looked like you. But I heard.
Amy Winehouse, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Amy. That was wonderful. Thank you.